see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Hello, and welcome to the It's in Queens podcast, the only podcast that focuses on Queens. I'm your host, Jeff Simmons, and each week I feature the people and the places of the borough that I call home. This podcast comes to you thanks to the Queens Economic Development Corporation and the Queens Tourism Council. Together, they present our borough as a fantastic place to live, to work, and to play. And this is certainly a period where there is so much to discover and enjoy in our borough. Why do I say that? Because in just a few days, we officially usher in the Lunar New Year. And this year, it's the Year of the Rabbit. It is a holiday celebrated around the world and, of course, here in Queens, home to robust Asian American communities. The New Year celebration centers around replacing the bad and the old with the new and the good. And it's a time to worship ancestors, exorcise evil spirits, and pray for a good harvest. Each year in the lunar calendar, which the holiday is based on, is represented by one of a dozen animals in the Chinese zodiac: rat, ox, tiger, rabbit, dragon, snake, horse, sheep, monkey, rooster, dog, or pig. The Year of the Rabbit occurs every 12 years, and here in Queens, the Chinese New Year festivities have already begun. Every year, I make a point of heading to the 7 train and go to the end of the line in Flushing to see the annual parade, which is coming up this Saturday starting at 11 o'clock, and to visit some of the amazing restaurants, although this year, I'm on a strict nutrition plan, so alas, I will not be able to dine like I normally would. And one of the places I work with, Flushing Town Hall on Northern Boulevard, has had bazaars and weeks of performances to celebrate the Lunar New Year in the past, and in just a bit, I'll tell you what they have in store. It's a lively, fun, and beautiful time to visit Flushing or any of the venues that celebrate the Chinese New Year. If you can't wait and you're itching to begin the celebration, well, this is the week. I caught up with Wesley Sin, Regional Marketing Manager for ShopCorp Properties, the owner and manager of the shops at Skyview and Flushing, to get an early look at what's in store. Wesley Sin, welcome to the It's in Queens podcast.
Hi, Jeff. Yeah, it's great to be here with you and It's in Queens.
I have visited the shops at Skyview a number of times. It's a very short walk from the 7 train, but before I get to why I wanted to have you on this week, I'd love for you first to tell me a little about the shops at Skyview. How large is it? Tell me a little about it.
Yeah, so the shop at Skyview, we have 700,000 square feet. Yeah, and you can find all your fashion favorites like Target, Old Navy, Uniqlo, and also discount deals at Burlington, Marshalls. And also we have Nike, Adidas, and Converse discount store at the center. Yeah.
How has it changed? I mean, you know, in recent years, I admit, during the pandemic, I didn't do shopping as much, but I've been out there much more now. So for anyone who hasn't visited in a while, what will they see that's new? What's drawing people in?
Yeah, so actually Burlington is new. We just opened last year. And also there's exciting news because this year Sephora is coming to Skyview. Yeah.
Oh, wow. That's great. I love to visit Flushing during this time of year, during Lunar New Year, and not just for the parade, but for various events like at Flushing Town Hall. What is in store at the shops at Skyview to mark the Year of the Rabbit?
So, you know, like next week will be the Lunar New Year, right? Oh, so wait.
When does the Lunar New Year start? First day?
Next Saturday.
The 21st.
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to redo that because this is going to appear on next Wednesday. So you could say this week.
Okay.
Hold on. I'll ask that question again. Okay. I'd love to visit Flushing during this time of year, during the Lunar New Year, and not just for the parade, but for all the events that are held, like at Flushing Town Hall. What's in store at the shops at Skyview to celebrate the Year of the Rabbit?
Yeah, so, you know, like this weekend, this Saturday is a Lunar New Year's Eve, right? So at Skyview, we're kicking off the Year of Rabbit actually this Thursday. Yeah, we have a live mural painting event, which we have six different Asian American artists who is going to do like a six large panel of mural at the center to celebrate the Year of Rabbit.
Well, and I'm assuming that's not the only thing. You must have a celebration coming up too.
Yes, and the main celebration is actually on the Lunar New Year day, which is on the 22nd, which is Sunday. So on that day, we'll have cultural performance, music performance, and like a photo booth, and a lot of exciting things for you to come.
You know, from what I also had read about online for older, well, I say older folks, of age folks, they'll also be able to get a complimentary glass of wine if you purchase something. You spend
Yes,
a
so
little bit.
that's for the event on Thursday. So, like in the Asian community, Lunar New Year is a really big thing. So that's why this time we try to find six Asian American artists from all the different background. One of them are from China, one of them from Taiwan, one of them from Japan, and one of them from the Philippines. So different Asian American artists, they are going to use their imagination and use their creation to celebrate their version of the Lunar New Year, the Year of Rabbit. So when the shoppers they come to see the live painting, they can also drink some wine like they're attending a gallery reception.
I love that idea. Have you any idea what the mural's going to look like?
There'll be like six different, totally different murals, and all of them are about Lunar New Year and about the Year of Rabbits. So people, if you are curious to see what the murals will be look like, please come on Thursday, and each artist will be interpreting their version of Year of Rabbit.
You know, I've seen photos of previous events. You draw a really large crowd. Who shows up? Who attends these events?
I think a lot of I think in Skyview we actually have a variety of shoppers. Yeah, including like Asian Americans and also like non-Asian Americans. So it's interesting because of course like Asian people are celebrating the Lunar New Year, so a lot of them will come here as a celebration. But a lot of like non-Asian customers also like to come and experience a different culture. Yeah, so this is also what we would like to show everybody, like come here to experience a different culture.
Oh, before I forget, going back to the mural, once it's painted, how long will that stay up? Is it just through Lunar New Year, or you're going to keep that up for a while?
No, this will be up there for at least 6 to 8 months. And also people can come and vote their most, I mean their favorite mural. And the winning artist will win a $1,500 reward. And also people who vote, you'll get a chance to win a raffle too.
Oh, that's great. I'm sure that's going to make one artist very, very happy in the end.
Yeah, so everybody can come here and to support your most favorite emergent artist.
You know, I think it's, I always, having worked with Flushing Town Hall, I always have assumed people know what the Lunar New Year is and what the customs are. You know, this time of year, just for anyone who's new to Lunar New Year, who might not know much, talk a little about how people celebrate Lunar New Year. What do you recommend people do during this occasion?
Yeah, so Lunar New Year is a special occasion for some Asian families, so people getting together and enjoy like some traditional food. And there are also like some traditional celebration, for example, giving people the red envelope, which symbolize the good luck. And if you come to Skyview on January 22nd, Sunday, you will be able to experience all of them. We'll be giving out red envelopes, and there'll be raffles, and there'll be a wishing trees, like people were writing the red wishing card and wishing yourself a good luck for the new year, or just write down your dream and you can hang it on the cherry blossom tree and it may come true. Yeah, so there'll be lots of like interesting cultural activity to for you to experience.
And you know, you and I have not talked before, and I know we're talking about Lunar New Year, but beyond just Lunar New Year, is there anything else you'd love to just, you know, highlight that's happening over the next few months or year? Anything else? You've mentioned what Burlington being new, but any new shops, things to look forward to the rest of this year at the shops at Skyview?
Yeah, as I mentioned before, Sephora is coming, so stay tuned for the opening day. And also, every month we actually have different event in Skyview. For example, the following month, the most anticipated holiday is Valentine's Day. We'll have a special event on the Valentine's Day, and March we'll have something for Easter. So every month you can check our social media and also check the SN Queens, right? So yeah, I think it's a Queen's page. We'll also let people know what's going on in Skyview and what they can expect.
Oh, I'd love for you to give details about the time and days of both of those events on Thursday and Sunday.
Yeah, so Thursday, the live mural painting event will be 6 to 8 p.m. And on Sunday, the celebration will be from 2 to 5 p.m. So join us for the evening and the afternoon.
And given that you mentioned that people can find these things, where should they go? I'd love for people to know a website or social media. Where should folks go if they want to learn more about the shops at Skyview, but also the events that you hold?
Yeah, you can visit our website at the shops at Skyview NY or Instagram and Facebook. The handle is also the shops at Skyview NY.
Wesley Sin, thank you so much for appearing here on the It's in Queens podcast.
Thank you so much for having me.
There is so much more to explore and discover this Lunar New Year in Queens. Here's a few highlights. The New York Chinese Cultural Center returns to the Queens Museum on January 29th to celebrate the Lunar New Year with folk dances, lion dance, kung fu demonstrations, and traditional arts and crafts. Back to Flushing Town Hall that I mentioned earlier, well, you can check out a photo exhibition starting this Saturday when there's an opening reception from noon to 2 o'clock. The exhibition is called This Is Home, and it tells stories of the AAPI community in New York City and abroad, how they live, work, love, and when needed, stand up for what they believe in. And then a bit later in the month, on the 29th again, I mentioned that date earlier for another venue, Flushing Town Hall presents a performance of How Bang a Rabbit. Each year, Chinese Theater Works celebrates the season with a traditional Chinese glove puppet production that features the 12 animals of the Chinese zodiac. And then later, on February 11th and 12th, Queens Theater presents The Monkey King, the Kung Fu musical in its Claire Shulman Theater. It's an original musical based on the legendary mythical figure from the beloved 16th century Chinese novel, Journey to the West. That is just a taste of all that's in store. But if you're looking for something else to do this month or in the future, we have you covered. That is where Rob McKay comes in. He is with the Queens Economic Development Corporation and the Queens Tourism Council. And each week, he highlights several of the more fascinating events that are happening in Queens.
Hey, Jeff. All this Lunar New Year fun, I want to tell you about something that's actually really kind of, I'd say, heartwarming in a deep way. And that is the King Manor Museum, which is located out in Jamaica. It's actually on Jamaica Avenue in King Manor Park. They're a historical house, and they're hosting a concert called The Redemption of Music on January 21st at 2 p.m. And it's a violist named Nisa Sunchuary Sunar, who is going to play work by Bach and Paganini and, you know, all the classical music, and talk about how the music has helped her survive as an autistic woman with schizoaffective disorder. So she'll play music and talk about how what the music does to her and how it makes her, helps her survive. It's really very powerful stuff. Again, that's at King Manor Museum, and it's on January 21st at 2 p.m. That's about it for all. Thanks, and hope to see you out partying and celebrating Lunar New Year. It's going to be a good one for you.
That is just a sample of all that's happening. Thanks, Rob. Now, I was wondering what the rabbit signifies, and I had read that it symbolizes longevity, positivity, auspiciousness, wittiness, cautiousness, cleverness, deftness, and self-protection. The new year brings new fortunes, and people can expect prosperity, hope, and calm. That is something we all need, especially these days. And if you want to, well, have some calm in your life, if you're worried about not finding anything to do in the next few weeks, well, we do have you covered, because you need to just head right over to the It's in Queens website. That website address is itsinqueens.com. And there you will find a bounty of activities in our borough, including ones tied to the Lunar New Year. And remember, when you head to any festival, or see any performance, or attend a parade, really when you go anywhere in Queens, remember to take a few photos and post them on your social media channels and tag us. Make sure to tag us on Instagram and Twitter. Use the hashtag #ItsInQueens, because who knows, your photo could become our photo of the week. I'm your host, Jeff Simmons, and that's it for this week's It's in Queens podcast. Happy Lunar New Year.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friendship.